Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we are going to be talking about B58 injectors. A lot of you have asked me about, you know, the failures that you've been seeing recently, what causes it, what you can do to prevent it from happening, and what you can do to prevent it from turning into a catastrophic issue if it does happen to you. So I'm going to share with you all of the information that I have, and hopefully this helps you keep your B58 reliable and working properly. Now, I'm just going to say up front that this video is basically going to indicate there's no smoking gun or like specific cause for these B58 issues. So there are a lot of different failure modes, a lot of different issues that can arise that can cause the injectors to fail. And it's not really unique to our cars, but I'm going to try to answer all of the most common questions I get. So hopefully it puts your mind at ease that some specific mod you've done or specific fuel you're running isn't turning your car into a ticking time bomb. So let's jump right into it. The first thing I want to do is talk about the B58 injector itself. And this is actually a pretty simple system. It's just a solenoid. What you have at the tip is where the fuel comes in. And you can see there's one very small hole. And then at the outlet, there are six tiny holes that the fuel comes out of. And then also at the top, you have your plug. So this is where it gets power. And that's pretty simply how it works. So like I said, it's a solenoid. The internals have a spring and basically a valve that blocks off the holes on the injectors. And when the injector gets power, a magnet basically moves that spring to allow fuel to flow past it and through those six holes at the end of the tip. So it's a very simple system. When it gets power, it opens up and releases fuel. And when the power goes away, it closes up and prevents fuel from flowing out. And then as you can see on the end also, there are a couple seals wrapped around the nozzle. So this just seals off the combustion chamber so that it can hold proper compression. So with that being said, such a simple component can only have a couple different failure modes. The first one is if the injectors are stuck open or leaking, and basically spraying fuel when there's no power to the injector. So that can happen when the spring or the internals are damaged, and after it opens up, it doesn't actually return back to the closed position. You can also have a damaged nozzle or damaged tip that allows fuel to spray from areas that aren't on those six injector holes, or it can just constantly leak. The other way that it can fail is if it's stuck closed, and this is one that I haven't actually seen. From a mechanical standpoint, I haven't seen there be an issue with the internals of the injector, but it can get clogged. So you saw how small those six nozzles were, and anything, any piece of debris, dirt, dust, whatever, getting into your fuel system can block it off and prevent it from spraying fuel properly. It can also happen from bad gas or just any contaminants in your fuel system. Now, the last failure mode that I've heard of is an injector seal failure. And if the injector seals get damaged, then it'll prevent the car from holding compression, which will of course cause a lot of issues. So you need those seals to be in good condition. And if you remove and reinstall the injectors, it's always recommended to replace the seals just like any other gasket in the engine to make sure you get a good seal in the combustion chamber. So if you have any of these issues, then the way that you feel it will be pretty similar. You'll get misfires. And that's typically what causes people the most headache. Because when you get misfires, you typically look at the spark plugs or the coil packs. So what I typically do is if I'm getting a misfire, for example, on cylinder one, I'll move the spark plug to cylinder two, and I'll move the coil pack to cylinder three. And after that, you'll drive the car around again and see if the misfire moves to a different cylinder. So in that instance, if it moves to cylinder two, I know it's a spark plug issue, or if it moved to cylinder three, I know it's a coil pack issue. But what some people are experiencing is you're still having the issue on the same cylinder. So it's not moving with the spark plugs or the coil packs. And that's a good indication that it might be a fuel injector issue. So there are a couple ways to see if the injector is stuck open. You can remove the spark plug. And if you see that the spark plug is wet and it smells like fuel, there's a good chance that that cylinder is running rich. You can also run logs to see if you have any issues with your AFRs, because sometimes it'll consistently show a richer AFR than your target, and that can indicate that you have some fuel leaking or excess fuel coming out of the exhaust. I've also seen another pretty interesting way to check for injectors being stuck open, where you basically remove the entire fuel rail and the injectors, point them into a bucket, and unplug the injectors so that they should always be closed and start the car. Now the car won't start, but while it's turning over, you can check to see if any fuel is coming out of the injectors, because like I said, without any power going to it, it should be normally closed. So if there's fuel coming out when you're trying to turn over the engine with the injectors unplugged, that's obviously an indication that there's a leak or damage or something causing the injector to be stuck open. Now, if the injectors are stuck closed, that's a lot more difficult to diagnose. Again, you can try to read your spark plugs to see if any of them are white or show any signs of running lean. You won't smell any fuel or anything, so you'll really have to try to double check and see if there are any indications that that specific cylinder isn't getting any fuel. You can also swap injectors around the same way that you swap around coil packs and spark plugs to see if that moves the misfire from one cylinder to the other. And that is, of course, a clear indication that the injector is the issue. Now, the third failure mode is one that I find really interesting. Some people have had their injector seals fail, and what happens is they can't find the issue, and so they finally do a compression test and find low compression on one of the cylinders, so they assume that the engine is bad. And in this case, I highly recommend replacing the injector, or at least replacing the seal, to see if your compression comes back. There are a few instances where we think that an injector has caused an engine failure, but simply replacing the fuel injector seal brings back your compression, fixes your misfire, and then you're good to go and continue driving the car. So now we're going to talk about what causes these injector failures. So again, if you have any dirt or debris in your fuel system, that can cause the injectors to be clogged. The most common reason for this I've found is replacing your fuel pump or adding an ethanol analyzer has a potential of introducing contaminants into your fuel system. So make sure when you're working on your car and replacing any fueling components, you're keeping it extremely clean. Don't leave it open and unattended for an extended period of time. Cover up any fueling components that are left out in the open with a shop rag or something to help prevent anything from getting into your fuel system. Also, it can just be caused by normal wear and tear. And injector failures are not unique to B58s or even BMWs. This is something that can happen on any car. So now let's talk about what it's not. And hopefully this helps us at least get on the same page for the information that has been shared with us. The big trump card that we have out now is there are completely stock cars with injector failures. So factory sealed, factory tuned, and they're still having an injector failure. Some of them have had multiple. And so what I would say is that it's not tied to any specific modification or tune or change that you've done to your car. It's something that simply can happen over time. So one of the most common ones that I've heard is it's due to a specific fuel pump running too much fuel pressure and basically putting too much demand on the fuel system is causing the injector failures. Now keep in mind, running a bigger fuel pump doesn't put more pressure behind your fuel injector. Just like running a bigger tire at the same 35 PSI isn't increasing the air pressure in your tire just because it's a bigger tire. You're running the same amount of fuel pressure just with a pump that can support a higher amount of flow. So just saying that a bigger fuel pump is putting too much pressure behind the injectors is kind of flawed logic. Now the other one is the increased demand from the injectors, so the increased flow and higher fuel requirements that come with, you know, a tune or a bigger turbo. And what that typically means is that the injector is open for longer, but not necessarily working harder. So if anything, running it at higher RPM and causing it to run at a higher frequency will put more wear and tear on your injector. But simply running the injector at a higher capacity and having it stay open longer isn't necessarily working the injector harder. So adding ethanol to your fuel or running a bigger turbo or anything that requires higher fuel requirements within the injector's limits is pretty much safe. I've also heard of some people claiming that it might be due to a specific tune. That is not something that I would run and blame an OTS map for or a custom tune. The fuel injectors themselves are very simple and the way that they run is all controlled by the DME. They all have calibrations and a lot of different things working to make sure that they're meeting emissions requirements and everything else. So it's not something that a specific tune would adjust to suddenly cause injector failures. I've also seen failures across all the different tuning platforms. So people that are on MG Flasher, people are on Boot Mode, MHD, And again, cars that are completely stock, so you can't really blame a specific software for causing these issues. Another thing that people have mentioned is there was a new injector part number. And again, we can't just tie it to this because the injector part number could have changed for any reason. They could have changed suppliers. They could have done a design change to reduce cost, in which case I'm sure a lot of you would be a little more concerned about moving to a cheaper component. They could have changed the design to make it easier to install or easier to manufacture. There are a lot of different reasons why a part number can change outside of them improving the quality and reliability. So that's not something that you can directly jump to assume that it means the newer parts are good or the vehicles made before, you know, 2017 have a worse injector. A lot of people are also concerned about ethanol, and the way that we run our ethanol, especially with our mixes, is really not going to cause a big issue. I've actually had my car parked with E30 for like 3 months and driven the car without a problem, but I do flush my system with 93 octane every once in a while. It is recommended not to leave ethanol in the tank for months and months, but as long as you're driving your car regularly, running mixes, and running a tank of 93 maybe every couple months, you should be good to go. It really shouldn't cause an issue. I've known people that have pushed it farther than that without a problem, but the recommendation is to flush the system just to make sure you don't have old ethanol sitting in the bottom of your tank. BMW also offers an OEM fuel additive that they recommend for people that live in countries with poor fuel quality. So that is something that you can run, but again, I don't think it's 100% necessary for most people. They really target it for specific countries and areas that have extremely poor fuel. So yeah, that's everything that I know about the fuel injector issues. Hopefully this answers your questions, and remember, your specific tune, fuel, all that stuff is not likely to cause an injector failure. If anything, it's just normal wear and tear. The most important thing is if you're experiencing a misfire, stop the car, diagnose the issue, don't continue driving it, because that's when you can increase the failure to something catastrophic like washing out your cylinders, or leaning out a cylinder that causes a piston ring failure, and that'll ultimately require replacing the engine. So hopefully this video helps. If you guys have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Thanks. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do